Sam. I think you look good with all my eyes and nerves.
You're the focus at the moment of all this fussing and talking.
It's nice. I'm almost 80. It's really nice to get the recognition of my I just hope something happens when this will come up again. I'll keep working. I had a lot of scripts come in the last month. Nothing to do anywhere near. So just, I'm a rancher and then I'll sit down and
rest. Well, you ride Western, not as good as riding English. I've got to ask you a couple of questions. What do you think? I mean, you hear the PGA. What do you think about the nominees tonight? What do you think about the class of directors that are putting out today?
I think it's starting good. I worked with Dan Petrie and Jewel Van Balin a lot. I wasn't just familiar with the others because that type of stuff. I don't watch TV very much. I think it's starting good.
Are you enjoying? I mean, are you feeling sort of nervous coming up to the end of the month?
Thank you.
it's the Dallas Critics Award, but not going to be nominated for an award in and of itself, because it comes from people about other directors who walk in my shoes, they do what I do, you know, because the aspects of making this film, there's a 3.9, there's a high dad, you know, it's real difficulty, they get that joke, whereas other folks may not, you know, so for all of us, five, very different film, which I like too. He's quite something. You know, for decades, if he likes something, it turns out lots and lots of other people like it too. So he's had an instinct. He's had a finger on the pulse. Take Russell's next film, Gladiator. I know that Stephen had the idea, you know, it's time for a film like Gladiators, and it's the origin of it. To both of his company as well as he's crushing it. Thanks a lot.
Nominated this year with good subjects, so that's a very telling thing, and I think that in many ways the television movie is taking over where features left off. We do see some very interesting feature films nominated, but a great deal of those interesting feature films are now being made for television. Yeah, money comes first. It's a big screen project. It's an event. And you're not seeing the studios make a lot of their Academy movies that they used to make. And some of the nominated Academy movies are very small pictures. No, I think he's a brilliantly talented filmmaker, a genius, and has redefined American movie making. He's now proven that not only can he make the most popular movies, but he can take difficult subjects and make beautiful, beautiful pictures out of them and travel all over the world, and I think he's a great filmmaker. And not only that, he's a good public speaker.
Two things. I have a gun in my pocket and I'm pleased to see you. I don't know who your nomination picks are for the Academy's.
Oh, voter.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
Who are you leaning towards as possible people that you think would be deserved, well, if you like this year's cast of nominees?
I think this year's cast of nominees is fantastic. And I'm a good Academy member, and I would never, ever discuss any feelings I have toward voting. I really feel that all the films nominated are really spectacular, and the only film that I felt deserved to be nominated for something was Any Given Sunday, and it isn't, and I don't know why, but that's all.
Oliver, you got it for use for editing, do you think?
Yeah, I don't think so, but at any rate, but there's some great pictures nominated, that's not denying it.
Okay, I tried to answer.
How proud are you of that man over there?
Without him, the Sixers never would have happened. I'm extremely thrilled.
And how about you? I'm a little nervous in any way, shape, or form when you're taking a day at a time. So you don't have any qualms, misgivings, or feelings about it?
No, I don't. I'm
not just
having a lot of fun.
Okay, so has it got you more dates, better clothing, new scripts? What's it getting for you?
I'm sure we're busy.
So what's going on next? You must have everybody wanting to work with you. So what's happening?
Well, I'm working on a film called Pay It Forward with Kevin Spacey and
Helen. Enjoy this. That's fine. Good script. What's going on next?
It's about a boy who's inspired to change the world.
I guess you'd be that boy. Thank you very much, Ed.
Thank you for your time.
Disappointed, you know.
This year, how about the spirit, youth,
I think that's very deep into his consciousness that he, what he loves is what the public loves. And now he, as he gets older and becomes interested in more complex issues, so have his films. So he's taking the audience along with him, which is a great sense.
Talk about him, please, if you could, personally, as a friend, because I know it takes a lot to get you to come from your ranch up north down to Los Angeles. So what about the man himself? Because he's always been exactly what he appears to be.
I always found him an extremely sweet person, warm and friendly and enthusiastic, which is probably the most important thing.
What do you think about this year's Coppola?
Well, of course, I'm rooting for being John Malkovich of Spike Jones because that's my son-in-law. But Michael Mann, wonderful director, all the directors here. I mean, this has been a great year for film, I think. Hopefully she'll be here with the Virgin Suicides next year.
Yeah, we actually talked to her about the Virgin Suicides.
Maybe we'll have her as one of the nominees.
Oh,
that would be fun.
Now, finally, what do you think about this year's crop of actors, directors, etc. from the Academy? Not picking, not choosing, that is not right. But how do you feel about this year's Academy?
This has been a wonderful year, mainly because of the independence film. There are so many films that came out this year that I wanted to see, and that upon seeing, I was very excited about. I think it illustrates that really it's creativity and independence that's doing it. It's certainly not the studio pictures. It's Boys Don't Cry and Happiness and being John Malkovich and on and on.
How many of you can get? Let's keep rolling.
You want to talk about hair? You betcha.
The system.
Forget that. Forget everyone's turn.
I know.
You are movies that are basically copies of all the movies. You don't want to make movies anymore.
What are you talking about?
I know.
the other side, please.